This is the Bobcat News. Working hard to keep you informed. At Baldwin Creek Elementary, every Bobcat matters every day.
Hello, Bobcats. Hope you had a great weekend.
Welcome back, Bobcats. I'm going to start us off with a trivia. What is at the end of a rainbow?
Are you nervous about whitetop testing? I know I am. Miss Curl will be giving us some strategies on how to deal with stress and test anxiety.
Hello, Bobcats. I'm here with Miss Curl to talk about some mindfulness things we can do during or before whitetop. What are some mindfulness activities we can use while testing?
All right, Bobcats. So we've learned lots of different mindful strategies. It's really up to you which ones are your favorites. The ones that I think could be most helpful next week, or this week, would be the lazy eight breathing, because you can either trace that on your palm, like this, just that lazy eight, or you can trace it on the desk, it's just, or on your leg, more of a sensory thing. You can also do the five finger, or the take five breathing, where you breathe in, tracing your hands upwards, breathe out, tracing down. And you just do that as many times as you need to feel calm. So those are two of my favorites, I think two that you students like as well. So I would suggest doing those. Also, one thing that helps would be just taking those slow, deep breaths, maybe even closing your eyes for a moment, just to really relax yourself.
Thank you. And why is it important to stay calm during?
It's important to stay calm during your testing because if you're really anxious or really worried about making a mistake, you're going to be way in your head and you will make a mistake. But if you try to calm yourself down, take your time, really read the questions carefully, you're going to do just fine on the test.
And how can we mentally prepare ourselves for whitetop?
Okay, so mentally preparing would look like just trying your best, knowing that it's okay to make mistakes, but being okay with those, still persevering, moving on with the tests, again, practicing mindfulness, taking those deep breaths, reassuring yourself, and using positive self-talk are great ways to get you through the test. So those would be some of my suggestions, especially like saying, I can do this, I'll be fine, I've got this, things like that.
And what kind of attitude should we have towards these tests?
All right, Bobcats, the attitude you should have towards these tests is just feeling proud of yourself and really positive. I mean, these tests are just there to track your progress to see how far you've come throughout the year. So just go into it being willing to try.
And how should we approach and start these tests?
I would approach these tests the same way. One thing that's really helpful is making sure you get enough sleep before your test. So make sure you go to bed on time, wake up on time, eat a good breakfast, practice some mindfulness, use that positive self-talk, and then right before you get started, if you're still feeling anxious, just take those couple of deep breaths, say, I'm going to try my best, and then begin your test. And just be patient, read the questions carefully. You guys will get this.
And is there anything else you would like to add?
I think that's it. I believe in you, Bobcats, and good luck on your testing.
Okay. Thank you. Bye, Bobcats.
Hallway transitions need to be much quieter with YTOP testing going on. So please do your best to be silent these next couple of weeks. John will be talking to Miss Jordan to give us some advice.
Hi, Bobcats. I'm here with Mrs. Jordan to talk about why it's important to stay quiet in the hallways. Why is it important to stay quiet in the hallways, Mrs. Jordan?
Hi, John. We have our statewide summative YTOP testing coming up, and it is pretty important to our school. We want you guys to do a good job. We want you to do your best. And part of that is everybody's responsibility, whether you're testing or not. So for the people who are testing, the rest of us really, really want to work on making sure we're quiet in the hallways, okay? It's really important that we're quiet so that we're not disrupting that's going on.
Thank you. How can we show respect to the students that are testing?
The best way is to make sure you're walking quietly in the hall, especially if you're transitioning between power-up times, if you're waiting to get into a class, like some classes are in different places. Just make sure you are quiet at a level one if you're standing and waiting, a whisper level. Just make sure you are quiet at all times.
And what classrooms have kids testing in them?
That's a good question, because we're kind of spread out this year. Of course, both of the labs will have testing all mm-hmm. the time. A lot of our extra rooms, like with Mrs. Hawsey, there will be testing here. There will be testing in Mrs. Robinson's room. There will be testing in Mrs. Mackey's room, Mrs. Show's room, Mrs. McFadden and Mrs. Mulholland. So we have testing even in Mrs. Powell's room, a lot of rooms. So don't think that you only have to be quiet around the labs. You need to be quiet all around the school, okay? It's really important. There's a lot of testing in a lot of places this year, so that's important, John.
Okay. Thank you. Bye, Bobcats. Easton, can you tell us what's happening next?
I wonder what's happening in sports this week. Becca, can you tell us what's going on with sports?
Hi, Bobcats. I have a trivia question for you this week. What is a taekwondo studio called? A dojo, B, a dojang, C, a gym, or D, a ring? Soccer players have been practicing indoors. There's a tournament in Casper on Saturday for the U12 co-ed team. Baseball skills practice was last Monday. Nice job, baseball players. Taekwondo have been practicing in the...
Becca, don't spoil it!
Sorry. Dancers are practicing their routines for upcoming dance competitions. Good luck, dancers. Wrestlers had a tournament in Lander this weekend. I'll get you the results next week. They also have state next weekend. Keep it up, wrestlers. The Blazing Bobcat reward is coming up. Keep running, Bobcats. By the way, if you were wondering about that trivia question, the answer was B, a dojang. Bye, Bobcats.
I wonder if weather will be warming up this week. But first things first, where in the world is Carmen Deniego?
Hi, Bobcats. I'm in Italy and glad to finally bring you the weather, so listen in. On Monday, expect 50 to be the high and 35 to be the low. It is going to be partly cloudy with a 3% chance of precipitation. Tuesday, we will have a high of 56 and a low of 33. It is going to be mostly sunny with a 3% chance of precipitation. On Wednesday, the high will be 46 and the low will be 32. Wednesday and the rest of the week will be partly cloudy. We have a 16% chance of precipitation. Thursday, the high will be 41 and the low will be 29. It will have a 32% chance of AM snow showers. Last and definitely not least, on Friday it will include a high of 40 and a low of 29. We will have a 47% chance of some rain or snow. I hope the snow will melt and spring will be here. See you next week, Bobcats.
Do you need something to read during YTOP testing? Here are some students that have read some pretty good books that they would like to share with you.
I'm recommending the book The Sisters Grimm because it's just about like fairy tales and it has adventures and it's about two sisters that love each other and will always protect each other. And yeah.
Hi, my name is Max, and today I'm going to be recommending The Incorrigible Children of Ashton Place. I like this book because it's about a governess who gets sent to a palace and work with kids that were raised by wolves. It's funny and full of energy.
Hi, I'm Ariana McComey, and I'm recommending the book I Funny from James Patterson. It has a bunch of funny jokes and fun experiences. There are more books, but my recommendation is I Funny. That is the funniest book to me so far.
My favorite book is Bad Kitty School Days. I like it because it's funny and Bad Kitty battles Uncle Murray. He hates Uncle Murray.
I recommend the Dear America Books, Diary of Lydia Amelia Pierce. It's about this girl that her mom and dad die, and then her little sister dies, and all she has left is her brother, and then they go to their uncle's, and then I'm not telling you anything else.
Hi, I'm recommending the series Keeper of the Lost City because it's a really good read, and it's about a girl who finds out she's an elf and is brought to other elves, and it's got lots of adventure and it's super fun.
My name is Carolyn Gallinger, and I think you should read the book Jack. It's a fairy tale, and it's kind of just telling about the Jack and the Beanstalk. It's telling about a good adventure of Jack.
Hi, I am Owen Hall, and I am here to recommend you a book. It's called Percy Jackson, the Lightning Thief. I think you should check this out because it's a really good book. It makes Greek mythology actually real, and I think that's really cool. And has a lot of adventure. It has a lot of fight scenes, and it's just overall great. It's worth a check out. So yeah, see ya.
Nolan will be interviewing this week's feature students.
Hello, Bobcats. Today we're here with our feature student, Alex. So, what books do you like to read?
Diary of a Wimpy Kid.
What do you like to do outside of school?
Dance and hang out with my friends.
And how do you think you demonstrate the Bobcat traits?
Helping students and teachers.
Hi, Bobcats. Today we're interviewing Sam Wilsbacher as our feature student this week. So, what books do you like to read, Sam?
I like to read the Diary of a Wimpy Kid series.
And what do you like to do outside of school in your free time?
Play sports and video games.
And how do you think you demonstrate the Bobcat traits?
Being safe, respectful, and responsible.
Thanks, Sam. Bye, Bobcats.
Here are the reminders for this week. YTOP testing will start tomorrow. 5th grade will be taking the writing assessment, and 4th grade will do science. Be sure to get plenty of sleep and try to eat healthy. It is also important to have positive growth mindset and know that you can do this.
The Noetic Math Competition will take place today. The math enrichment students are excited to show what they know, so wish them good luck.
Let's see who's listening to the news. We will be giving you a secret phrase somewhere in the broadcast, and you just need to write the phrase on a piece of paper, and don't forget to write your name on it, and then drop it in the box in the library before the end of the day on Tuesday, and you could win something exciting.
Keep checking the lost and found for your items, keep reading to reach your AR goals, and keep walking or running to earn your Blazing Bobcat miles. The answer to the trivia was W. You may have thought it was a pot of gold, but that is only in stories. Bobcats, have a great rest of your week.
The phrase is April snow makes me slow. See you, Bobcats, and let's try your best on the white top.